But first tonight, that massive project in Detroit aimed at righting an historic wrong. We want to welcome you to 7 Action News at 6. I'm Carolyn Clifford.
And I'm Dave Llewellyn. An infusion of $105 million in federal funding will give the state the power to rip out I-375 in downtown Detroit.
When the interstate went in some 60 years ago, it cut right through two historic black neighborhoods, forcing more than 130,000 people from their homes.
I-375 links I-75 to Jefferson downtown. 7 Action News reporter Mike Duffy walks us through the new vision and the significance to so many Detroiters.
This is I-375 today. But before 1960, when this highway was built, it was home to the communities of Black Bottom and further down the road, Paradise Valley. Now, Hastings Street was the main commercial corridor, but it was paved over to build this road. People I spoke with today reacted to the news that this ground that we're standing on right now will be a neighborhood once again.
This whole area where Lafayette Park is and these apartments, that was once a domain of black folks, in part because they were discriminated against and couldn't move anywhere else.
William Oakes already had opinions about the project, even before U.S. Secretary of Transportation Pete Buttigieg made the $105 million funding announcement alongside Governor Gretchen Whitmer and Mayor Mike Duggan Thursday.
So they built their own neighborhood, and that neighborhood was destroyed by urban renewal in the 1950s and 60s.
He's talking about the communities of Black Bottom and Paradise Valley. Hundreds of homes and businesses destroyed, neighborhoods divided as a result of the Federal Highway Act of 1956.
A generation or two of black wealth has been lost. So it's great that it's going to be a boulevard, but what does it do for all those folks who were displaced?
Jamie Kendrick Jones reacted to the reality of the project actually happening.
It's humbling because we wait so long for things to happen and change to come, and we fight so hard. So I think it's really, really good.
She wants to make sure it's benefiting the local community.
So as long as it's helping people and not hurting people or making things worse than they already are, then I'm down. I'm all for it.
And she's encouraged to see the momentum for Detroit.
So as long as it's helping people and not hurting people or making things worse than they already are, then I'm down. I'm all for it.
Councilmember Coleman Alexander Young II, who was also at Thursday's announcement, told me about his dad being from the neighborhood.
Did he ever talk about what happened when the freeway went in?
Oh, he talked about all of it. He talked about all of it. There's some stuff in his W I can't say on television he talked about, but he talked about all of it.
Detroit's not alone. The interstate system has had negative effects on communities throughout the U.S. Now Detroit is attempting to right past wrongs.
A lot of people talk, but few people do. And so I think that's what we're doing.
In Detroit, Mike Duffy, 7 Action News.
Mike, thank you. This is certainly more than your average road project. To read more about the I-375 modernization plan and the history behind it, go to our website, WXYZ.com.